Here we go. My name Bishop Bullwacker, from the First Church, nothing but the truth. Deacon Kyle, Deacon George, Deacon Clay, open the door, let them in, turn them loose. First, I want to thank God for the blood running warm in my veins. That's all right. Thank God for my life, health, and strength. I got a sound mind. I'm not insane. Come on, come on. I ain't gonna preach too long. Ain't gonna take the service too far. My sermon this morning. Hell to the no, no, no. Come on, come on. Come on. Hell no. To the no, no, no. Hell to the no. Hell to the no. To the no, 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 no. Listen. Sister Edda, Sister Ruth, y'all ushers, make sure that everybody get a seat. To go in the kitchen, cause when I get through, I need to eat. Come on! Fix me collard greens and cornbread and rice. Chicken breasts, oxtails on the side. That's all right. Deacon Frank, get my dark truck ready, cause when I get through, I need to ride. Deacon Big Rob, count the money, come back, tell me what you raised. I got some people day looking for some blessings, but now God got to get the praise. Woo! There's an old saying, when the praises go up, you get the blessing coming down.
Yeah,
I got some peoples in the church, huh? And they still, they're messing around. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 listen. I got peoples in the church today hugging you. They claim that they love you to death.
They'll do that.
But time to get home, they on the telephone talking about they can't stand your breath.
Yeah.
I got peoples in the church smoking weed, drinking whiskey, drinking vodka, a lot of gin.
What you say?
I got the preacher with the night prayer meeting talking about can I get an amen.
Talk to him.
Every Sunday morning, about a quarter, about a half past ten.
Come on.
I got some faggots, got some bull daggers. I got some hoes and dope addicts, they're coming in.
That's right, that's right.
And now they're laying at the altar, and they confess the sin, their sin, yeah.
Come on, Bishop.
The time you see them Monday morning, doing the same thing again.
Come on.
Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 listen. I got kids dropping out of school, talking about they don't want to learn. But they're standing on the corner, rolling blunts, talking about come on, let's burn.
They'll do that.
I got kids walking up and down the street, pants hanging down by the knees.
Look at them, look
talking
at
about that they're looking for a job. When I see them, I say, did it, bug, please.
That's what they need to
see. See all they ever talk about, brag about who got the biggest and the baddest gun. Time to see the copper with the bubble top, and they drop the Glock, they wanna run.
Yeah.
And now the sheriff got them locked up, got them sitting in the county jail.
What not?
Heard the mama, she was crying all night, cause she can't get money for the bill. Now they're mad with the homeboys, cause they didn't put no money in the commissary.
Yeah, yeah.
Be glad you're in the jail, brother man, cause you were sure headed for the cemetery.
That's a fact.
There's an old saying that a hard head make a soft behind.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, since you did the crime, don't do the time, stop the baby crying. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 no. Hell no, no. To the no, no. Hell to the no, no.
To the no, 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 no.
Hell to the no, no. To the no, no, no.
To the no, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
to the no, no, to the no, 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 no,
hell.
To the no, no, to the no.
Here we are, another episode of The Artistry of, but who are we brought to you by? Well, my friend, We are brought to you by BoNosMusic.com. Oh! That's right. BoNosMusic.com is back, bitches. You thought BoNos Music was gone forever? Well, it's back. It's up and running. Go there today. Start up a free account so that you can get on your road, get on your path to learning music, learning this piano and jazz music, pop music, church music, whatever music at BoNosMusic.com. We're also brought to you by Fidlu.com. That's right. He's working on an axe right now, and that thing looks gorgeous. But how can you guys see it? Well, in a little bit, you might be able to tune in on a live cast, which our listeners now don't know about. So by the time you guys hear about it, it'll be over. But for those of you who will be hopping on pretty soon, you're going to see this thing. This is a pretty instrument. Go to fidlu.com. Check it out. He's going to upload the pics, upload the price, make sure everything is nice, and get you guys going, okay? That's what it's all about. Picking up a sweet axe, learning this instrument, and being that bass player you want to be. Where? At fidlu.com. Last but definitely not least, weebly.com. Go there. Sign up, start your online presence, build your website, get everything going so that you can send people to your website and you can start making money doing what you love to do. So, how can you do it? Go to Weebly or go to BoMiles.com, click on the Weebly link somewhere, or Fidlu.com, click on the Weebly link and get started today. Today, my love. Gars.
What's up?
And now, it is time for us to begin what can only be the beginning of the beginning.
Cue the music.
Let me introduce you to BoMiles.
What's up?
So,
you like the culture?
We're trying to get this party started right. Get this thing popping online. You guys been asking for it for almost a year now. Hey, man, Bo and Fid, when you guys going to go ahead and simulcast this puppy? Video, connect the video with the audio, giving full 360 degrees human interaction. When are you guys going to do it?
What's up?
Well, never fear. We are on the path right now as we speak. So hopefully by the end of this episode, you guys, I will be letting you know how to tune in, what days we record, so that you guys can catch this stuff live before everyone else. Because you figure, I mean, the episodes post on a Sunday, but today is Monday.
Do I have to shave?
Hey, nah, man. You just got to be yourself, man. That's what you got to do.
For me to stay here, I got to be me. You'll never be in doubt. That's what it's all about. You can't take me for granted and smile. How could you ever allow? I guess I wonder how. When you get out of pocket for fun, how? When you know that you're never number two, number one's gonna be number one. I'll be good. You know I wish I could get the message over to you now.
Oh, man. Fizz is not playing.
Oh, man. Anytime I touch a bass, my juices flow. They flow even more when I'm making them.
Oh.
You know, it's a sickness. I need help with this here.
Hey, man, look. You just gotta do it.
You know, people don't know. Stradivarius did that not because he needed the money. He had a sickness.
See, man, I'm looking at this. Oh, all right. Maybe I gotta check the email skis. They're gonna send me the link so that I can download this
app.
What's app? Other than that, while we're looking for that, man, I revamped the Bono's music site, you know. Yeah, man. So, you know, I'm definitely feeling good. I put up the Fletcher Henderson little thing on him so that people can kind of remember those and learn those of you who don't even know about Fletcher Henderson. I put that up and put the video up. Just a guy who helped usher in swing music, you know, who helped really just lay that foundation of playing, killing, way back in the 1920s, you know. But he was born in like the 1800s, you know, so yeah, man. So that's up. Got the welcome video, man. Just, you know, been putting in that time, and now I'm not ready to do a full out launch, but we are in a soft launch, so that's good there, man. Oh, and I got a chance to watch the Hateful Eight.
Hateful Eight.
Yeah, I was
watching.
What'd you
think of it, man?
Man, I thought it was pretty good, man. I mean, I thought it was really good. I like the way. This podcast will be packed with spoilers, like. So if you haven't seen it and you was thinking about it, you might as well just go ahead and cut this now.
You know what? It's been out long enough.
Well, just let them know. You got to just let them know.
You know, take your asses to the movie.
Because
it's been out a month.
So, yeah. You know, just right now, we're about to talk about it. So if you haven't seen it and you want to see it, go ahead and stop it now.
It's probably out on bootleg by now.
Oh, man. Who knows? But, yeah, man. I thought it was really good. I like the way Tarantino, how he just... It was real dialogue heavy, you know, but it kept you engaged.
It seemed more like it was a stage play because most of the drama was done in one scene.
Right.
One setting. One setting. Yeah.
Right. Right. I mean, you figure. I mean, you could do the Hateful Eight as a stage play. I mean, it was done. Just really two settings, really, and that was it. That's all you needed. And other than that, I mean, you was ready to go, so.
Yeah. The only problem I have is there was just an exorbitant use of the N-word.
That's whack. You know, man, like, yo, that's the language. You know, you can't.
Well, you know what?
You got to be true to the time.
I'm talking about for today's purposes.
Oh, just like people use, like people today listening or what?
Well, you know, if it's hurled at a person in a movie, and you know, those were the times, but it was written today.
So yeah.
It's not depicting an actual event. It's a fictitious story.
Right, but it's to represent the timing of today. You know, so that's why I feel like, hey, they was just, look.
Well, see, he was okay with it in the movie, but he got his back. You can't do what he did and get away with it.
Oh, with which one?
Samuel L.
All right, let's try to set this up so that we can get me and you in this. People can see us.
What do you see me for? I ain't shaved.
Yeah, man. Look, you know, this is where we need to go with this.
Hollywood for swingers.
So here, let me. So we enabled this.
Twinkle, twinkle, baby.
So now. But anyway, guys, I'm trying to set this up. But I feel like, okay, you wrote this story. And it takes place in a time where people, you know, would heavily use that word. So it's like, look, you got to use it. You have to be true to the time, you know. So if the time calls for it, if this is the way they talk during that time, then we got to run with it, you know. So that's my only thing. Like, that's why I feel like, yo, we have to just be true, you know, to that time. And
yeah, that's correct, but I don't know.
I mean, but I feel you, though. I mean, but I enjoyed it, man. Like, yeah.
Oh, I enjoyed the movie.
Yeah, they used nigger a lot, man, but hey, it was just, that's the way people used it, you know, and that was the feeling towards black people at the time, so.
It still is today.
Right, man. It is, you know.
It ain't changed. It's just not politically correct to do it.
Right. But it's... People are... They have changed, you know. Not everybody feels like that. And not everybody wants to.
Well, some people feel as though that since some blacks use it excessively... Well, you call each other the N-word. Why can't we call you the N-word? Oh, you want to use it on me? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, some people, they do want to use the word, but I feel like it's because they get in trouble for it. It's like anything where you say, okay, you can't do this, you can't do that. Well, why? You know, now I want to do it.
Well, that's just ignorance.
So, you know, I feel like, hey, it is what it is. People want to use it. They're going to use it. And
But you're going to get yourself in trouble. That's the problem.
Right. It is politically incorrect to say the word. And it's not even about the words. It's about the feelings that are attached to it. If you... truly feel like, you know, people are superior and inferior to one another, like humans are different based off of the color of their skin, you know, then it's like, yo, that's kind of stupid, you know.
Well, we have a president, and I'm not saying what his name is, but we have a president who's under his administration destroyed most of the terrorist leaders. Let's forget about all that other stuff. Let's look at one thing. We got gas under $2 a gallon. Okay? The economy's recovered. He can't make jobs, and he won't be able to as long as the government allows them to send jobs out of the country. And see, that was done under Reagan's term, NAFTA. Yeah, it was signed in under Clinton, but Reagan did that.
So what was that? That's what?
Free trade. They can come dump all their stuff in our country at cheaper prices. Or... we can have stuff made out of the country, ship it back in. Like right now, they're making all the stuff in China. I mean,
okay.
And you know, most of the jobs are leaving the country. The only jobs left, truly in this country, are like business type jobs where nobody's going to allow somebody from another country to run their business. Okay, the owners. Wall Street is not going to allow other countries to run Wall Street, work in there and run Wall Street. So the only type of jobs left that the common people can have are factory jobs are gone. Steel mills are being systematically destroyed. The only thing left are technical positions, medical positions, working at McDonald's, Burger King, and Rally Burgers.
Yeah.
So, basically, if you don't get an education, you got to work 3 shifts at Burger King.
Right.
Just to raise a family. And see, those jobs were originally meant for college students, high schoolers. And then it turned into where old people started doing them. So,
and that's where we are now,
That's where we are now. We got young people who don't have educations who are trying to run their families off of those jobs. And you can't raise a family off of that. I mean, really. You cannot run a household off of them, off pennies.
Yeah. I mean, that's the thing, man. If you just look at just the money, you know, you're trying to follow the money. Hey, what's going on? And it's not there. And that's even if you look at the coal jobs, you know, here in West Virginia, a lot of people like Obama has a war again on coal. But it's really, I wouldn't say that it's Obama. It's just competition. Other industries are coming in and...
It's easy to blame him. He's the person you want to blame. You didn't go to you didn't finish high school. That fucking Obama. You know, I don't have a job. Well, did you finish high school? Did you try to go to a trade school? Did you go to college? I mean, come on. You know, take responsibility for yourself. Quit blaming our president.
Yeah, that's one thing. We always tend to look for people to blame. It's like, all right, we have to.
He did it. It's his fault.
Right. My daddy can't get into the military, you know, because something that someone else did. You know, it's like, look, man. I mean, you can try to blame other people if you want. But in actuality, it's like, look, that's not the issue. The issue is...
Well, they have a minimum education requirement. So you can't even get in the military anymore if you don't finish high school. Because they got so many to pick from.
All right, so we're almost up. It's retrieving our content. And then I'm going to angle it so that we can kind of get an idea. Then we can really... start this puppy.
I'm going to put these headphones on so I can look important.
He's like...
Well, you sorry?
Yeah, so...
Hello?
That's the thing, man. We got to angle. We got to really angle this puppy.
I'm on the air.
So that...
Let me buy.
We can... So we can get this puppy rolling, you know.
Offline.
Yeah.
What that mean, man?
It means it's pulling everything together. I do have for the stream, so let's see. Sartre encoder, which we did. Status bar will indicate when we're live. Oh, here it is, starting. So we're about to start up. Your stream is complete. It will automatically create an upload for your fans to view later. I wonder how much time we can...
Can
live stream. We'll figure it all out, guys. As we
go?
Yeah. As we go, starting up. So it's about to kick in. And then we'll just kind of push this back. I'll push it back until you can see...
Or you can come on this side.
Yeah, I'll just do it to where it's like, all right, you can see.
How about this?
All right, so. Okay, we are live. Now, I had it to where we would, where's this? This is the camera. All right, so we have, and then that's going to be the feedback. So we're going to have to just move it away from the mic. And then it should be good. There we go. So now.
Oh, it's delayed.
It's like a 15-second delay, man. So that way they can edit us if we do something wrong.
Yeah, so I guess both of us just sit in the...
This side over here, man.
No, we both scoot close, you know what I mean? And just kind of sit over like this. Then we'll be in there. But I wonder, what's up with the sound, though? That's the real question.
Why is it?
Oh, that hissing or that?
Yeah, that's loudness. That's
That's some type of so if you here.
Yeah. Let me turn my phone off. You think that'll help?
Nah, man, I don't know if it's this phone. I think it's our stuff.
Causing feedback?
It's something. It's either our.
Can you adjust that angle on it?
Yeah. See, I can't. I don't know. The sound. It's not good.
I'm wondering if they can hear it.
Yeah, see, I mean, I don't know. I don't know if you guys can hear it or not.
We'll do this.
Let's see.
Here.
There. Maybe check that. Yes, because you can hear it. I can hear some sound in the back. Like I can.
I mean, we should not be having feedback from... Because we're not, this is going directly to this, so they're not tied into it, so why are we getting this feedback?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know where the feedback is coming from, but. But yeah, like you said, it's probably like a little 15-second delay. We'll figure it out. This is our first stream of the artistry of, but we'll.
Man, you cut in half, man. There you go. There you go.
Yeah, because I want to get you in there.
Oh, I'm not important, man.
Yeah.
I'm the invisible man. I got no parts.
That's why you got the camera, man. You was like, look, we need to do this simulcast.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out where that feedback's coming from, man.
So we'll have to see, because man, most guys, like, they'll have it away, you know, probably have it like further back, and then they get to see
everything.
Yeah, see, that's good. Yeah, we can maintain that. I know you guys who are going to be getting this thing a little bit later, Sunday, will.
Well, how long will it stay on YouTube?
I believe until you pull it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow, that's deep. Twinkle, twinkle, baby. I'm a star.
Right. So yeah, man, this is looking, this is looking good. I mean, hey.
Oh, wow.
So, let me see. The only issue is with the sound, but that's the output. That's not the, I don't believe that's the input of the mics, of our mics. So, let me see if I can put on like a...
Is anybody out there? There? Hello? Hello? Is anybody listening? Listening?
So, yeah, stream.
What's the saying, man?
So we don't have anybody watching right now, but
that's okay.
Eventually, you know, somebody will jump on. We can also share it to Twitter. So we'll figure that out, man. But
so let me ask you.
Yeah.
Can we hook a camera to your system? Wide angle camera? Like the Zoom 8 that I have?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can have one extra camera.
Oh, wow. So would they split the screen for us?
No, that's with the other one. With that program that I downloaded, Wirecast. With the Wirecast, I believe you can see the two different cameras.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I guess... But see, that's where you need another person that's kind of moving it back between, because like, you really can't focus on the conversation. Like, for us to really be having a conversation and worried about switching it off, like, that's going to be tough.
So let me ask you, how are we going to look up our booty calls and stuff if our computer... We need two more computers or something, bro. We got to...
For what? To bring the...
Like we did last week.
Oh, all right. Yeah, yeah.
Go to the back page and all that good stuff, man.
Right, man. I mean, you know, eventually we're not going to be there at that level. First level will just be like...
One, experimentation.
Yeah, yeah. One camera on until you need another person to handle that. Because, like, I can't really think about what's going on and what I need to fix and talk and have a conversation with you at the same time. Like,
if you're skilled, you can.
No, you can't.
Oh, yeah, you can. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, we'll see you develop. We'll see you develop that skill, and you just tell me how it's going for you, man. Yeah, man, you go ahead and develop that.
All right.
Yeah, man, but, that Hateful Eight, man, back to that, which...
Oh, yeah.
Man, I felt like the... It was just an all-around good story. I mean, it wasn't like... prolific or anything, like, man, this is heavy in thought, but just the representation, and I believe it's still up, but just the representation of all the characters, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, which I felt like it was still a continuation of Django, far as with the bounty hunter. Like, he really loved
the theme, worked, so he was doing it a second time. You're supposed to double down. That theme is a bounty hunter. That worked for him. So he liked that. I guess there were black bounty hunters back then. They had black sheriffs, too.
Right, in some small towns?
Yeah, out west. You know, after the Civil War, a lot of freedmen went west, and they cohabitated with Native Americans. They cohabitated with the Native Americans a long time, so... You know, they dilute history for a purpose, because if they didn't, we would know that once upon a time, people got along.
Right.
And you can't have that. It's called divide and conquer. And if people got along, they can't control. And that's what it's about, control. Divide and conquer.
Yeah. And they showed, like, even with the mama, whatever her name was, the one, the restaurant owner, or the,
uh-huh.
Like, they showed her, and then they had regular white people during that time, all just, you know.
Cohabitating.
Yeah, but, like, it wasn't no problem. The guy, you had,
no.
You know.
But it's done for a purpose. It's done for control. And that's what it's about. It's about controlling the masses, and we're puppets.
Right. And, man, I liked how they had the story. They had the, this is just a plot. And those guys had a plan, but the weather, what they didn't count for was the weather. And then the new sheriff. And, you know, like, I like how he added those two elements that just seemed random. Like, you know, it wasn't about the hero, which would have been Kurt Russell. It wasn't about him overcoming, but it was about just circumstances that we don't plan for. It's the things that we don't plan for that usually take us out, and that's what happened with this gang.
The truth be told, we don't know if he really was the sheriff.
Right.
Because they never got to that town.
Yeah. But I think maybe he was. I mean, he pretty much knew. But at the same time, that guy who was pretending to be the hangman, like, he knew the hangman's story as well. So maybe he did kill them.
Oh, he had his business cards and everything.
Right. So maybe he did.
All four of them were there for that girl. One was a brother who was under the, who was down in the basement.
Yeah.
The other one, the tall one, not the Mexican, but the tall one. he was her. I think he was her boyfriend. I mean, yeah. But that Kurt Russell beat the shit out of her. No way to treat a lady.
Right. But first hey, time, man, but a criminal, you know, you gotta let him have it, man.
Man, the first time you see her, she got a black eye. Right. He even beat the shit out of her. And she spit on his letter. That was the worst thing to do. Spit on his letter.
Yeah, that
from
he
Abraham
made,
Lincoln.
Right, that he created himself. That was...
Yeah, that was wild.
Right, man. That was good. I really did. I liked it. I liked the dialogue in it as well. And I liked how, you know, like they just had the potential sheriff, and he was just talking about Southern and Northern politics, and you know, Samuel gets mad. He's like, look, man, I mean, I'm not talking about, you know, racism. I'm just talking about politics.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm totally separate from it. I'm separated. It's all about...
But that's what the politics is about, separating you so that someone can control. You know, you have to label somebody as a bad person in politics.
Right.
And yeah. Who's the most likely candidates?
Anybody. Poor.
Well, if this was a homogenous society, meaning all white people... They would find the dark-haired people that be the problem, or the blue-eyed people, or the green-eyed people, or the dark.
Yeah, whoever wins. I mean, if the dark-haired people have the majority of the numbers and they have the power, they have the money, then blonde hair will be, you know, it'll be like just blonde-haired devils, and that will be wrong. I mean, it's all about whoever the winner gets to say what is right and what is wrong.
Yeah.
You know, like... We're so used to the promotion of blonde hair, blue eyes, but there could be a situation where that is seen as inferior. That is seen as the subgroup, and now people, no one wants it. You know, like that is a possibility.
Yeah.
You know, of our just our monkey like ways,
chimp ways.
Yeah, our chimpness just hiding its ugly butt.
Rearing its ugly head.
Yeah, you know, so.
Primitive.
Yeah, and all of those thoughts are in just the Troglodyte. Interaction. The interaction Manithal. In those characters.
Caveman.
Man. Yeah.
Cave woman.
All types of subhuman noise.
Subhuman.
Yeah. The skeleton records don't lie.
They don't know. This is an old planet.
Yeah. Oh man, I was on a website and it was saying how this was a white person talking, texting. This is why I love the internet, because the internet really gives you an idea
the of pulse of society,
of reality. You know, as you go back and past, because the internet is all about what is it when you anonymity. Anonymity is yeah. When you, you know, like you're not taking responsibility for whatever you're doing or saying.
You feel it's like you're driving down the street and somebody's driving down the street. Then you're in your car, they're in their car, and they throw something out their window at you, and they think they're safe for right. Doing that, or that road rage thing.
Yeah, you know, and that's the thing. As you go in the past, you had more of it. It's like the internet now, like. People are, because they have the cloak of the internet, they say, it's not even, yeah, I don't even know if it's how they feel, but it's just that anger and it's just that hatred that they have somewhere, you know, that they have inside. Like most of the time, you figure, man, it's like music. If you're born in the time, you can do the music. Like, it's not even that you love it. You just can do the music. You can just... speak the language. It's like we're brought up in English, and the people that you surround yourself around is the language that you portray. That's the language that you use in everyday life. And it's not even a feeling. It's just the language that you use.
Well, you know, there is no anonymity. The people who think they're anonymous, they aren't. NSA is watching you, listening to your every phone call. They listen to every, they're watching this right now.
Right.
So there's no anonymity. Some people feel comfortable. Whatever you do or say, it's gonna be out there henceforth and forevermore. So, you know, you got to be careful what you say. Whatever you write on the internet is out there. Whatever you post, pictures you post, don't post your children on there, because people will single you out for your kids.
Yeah, but at the same time, like, all right, people are watching, but they're not. You know, like, it's no consequence to what they're watching. Like, it's so many people, it's so much information being collected on the internet that it's like, well, what can they do? You know, how can they single you out? Like, how can they single me and you out?
Keywords.
All the crazy stuff.
Keywords.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Like, all the crazy stuff that we do and that we say, like, nothing is happening because no one truly is watching us. Like, yes, the stuff is being recorded, but it's not like Obama. Well, you know, like, they're watching Obama and Hillary.
Yeah, we are not terrorists. We're not militants. We're just an old guy and a young guy.
Yeah, but man, you gotta
expressing
think.
Expressing our opinion.
Yeah, but they have some radical. There's some radical people that stand some crazy, violent stuff, and they're going. They're just plotting up, getting everything together.
They're like, watching them.
Yeah, but they're not doing anything. Like they're, you know,
they got a file on them.
Yeah, it's like we give the government, we give people too much credit, and it's like, okay, it's really not.
How you think they catching all these terrorists?
It's really not that with leads, because think about the ones that they're not catching. When you think about an attack, like what happened in Paris. Like,
okay, that's Paris. They don't have what we got over here.
Even in America, look at those.
Okay, that last act was a random act between a husband and wife.
No.
Acting on behalf of a terrorist society. They cannot plant a wire in everybody's house.
But see, that's what I'm saying. But there is a trail. Like, you can see a trail of things that's building up to, okay, this is where they're going. They were already being radicalized. They were, like, you know, they already had things going on.
But you know what, though?
For a government that's truly watching, the government wasn't watching.
But you know what? The government is who allow these people in.
Right. Oh, think about Philly, that black guy who shot the cop. And there's going to be more cases like that. Like, the government, they didn't know anything about it. They wasn't watching him. And think about all the crack dealers. It's like, we just give them too much credit. Like, yeah, they are watching.
Okay,
but they not.
I'll come visit your ass.
Yeah, look, man, you're not, man. I'm telling you, you're not going to visit me because.
Nope, because once they take your ass over to Guantanamo Bay, Cuba, and start waterboarding your ass.
Yeah. Look, man, you're going to be like, I told them.
Dude,
like,
let me tell you something. They get who they want to get. If they let them out, if they let them stay out there, they doing it for a purpose.
Man, it's like the lottery, man. It's like, it's random, but people, because there's so many, right? So many people, you got a 1 in 1 million, 200 million chance of hitting, but somebody has to hit. So you think, like, okay, I come up with this strategy, I come up with this, I do that, maybe it'll increase my odds, but your odds never change. Like, someone has to get hit. Like, we have to have criminals. They're going to get, you know, popped up, but... And I'm not saying that those conspiracies, like, where people, you know, have some type of really good information and then they get killed and it's, mm-hmm. we never know that it was a murder. It just looks like natural causes. Like, I believe in that type of stuff, but at the same time, man, I don't think the government is as powerful as people think.
We aren't that important. But if somebody like P. Diddy would start to spouting militant ism, he'd be on the top of the list, man. Because he has control of the masses. We don't have control of the masses.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, man. I mean, I agree with you.
Jay-Z, Kanye West. Kanye, they got to foul long as his arm on Kanye West. You know? But they already know. They already know how to deal with the Kanye Wests. There was this one Arab terrorist that they were trying to get. Couldn't get him. They tracked him down for years. You know how they finally got him? He wanted a white wife. So they set him up. They found this white Muslim, blonde-haired Muslim lady. They set him up. They ended up marrying him. Now they knew exactly where it was, where his trail was. And they killed him. So they know what they're doing. They get you if they want you. If you're that important.
Right, but see, that's the thing, man. There's so many people that are important. You know, but it's like...
Truly, we aren't that important.
Right, I mean, yeah, of course, me and you, but there's still others. There's still people out there that's, you know...
You don't think they have a file on... What's the guy's name? With the hair slicked back who do the television show now. Wow. Used to be heavy set, lost a lot of weight.
Oh, Jared?
No. Black guy.
Used to be heavy.
Reverend
Al Sharpton?
Yeah, Al Sharpton. Yeah. They got a follow on Sharpton.
Yeah, but like the stuff that they got and the ways that they tap, like they're tracking them, are not as sophisticated as we would believe. You know, like they still have to implant the bug. They still have to do all that stuff. Oh, like, yeah. Like, it's not to where, like, they can just pick up,
No, they just can't. They can't. Well, I don't know. They right. got stuff out now, man. They can point a light at you and pick up words you're saying.
Right.
They got light microphones. So don't underestimate anybody, man.
Right.
Just be careful what you say, man. So... When you go plan something, let me know, Bo, so I can stay my ass away.
yeah, man. Don't worry. The FBI will already be on it, and they're going
to... I'm not trying to be a martyr for anybody.
They're going to come and let you know, like, you know, man, what you know.
If everybody would take care of their own, like they're supposed to, do all the things that they're supposed to do to prepare themselves for life, we wouldn't have no complaints. You know, it's like... Okay, I'm going to be honest. I don't know what I would have done with my life had I not gotten a college education. I don't know where I would be right now. Okay, so I can't say what if. I know that because I got an education, it's made my life easier. I didn't get all the fine jobs I wanted, all the top-rate jobs I wanted, but I had a steady lifestyle and a steady living. Okay. I can pick up and go wherever I want to go. I can pick up part-time work. I can teach. I can do so many things with an education. I can hang up my own shingle. I can start my own company. I can do all these things with an education. So to say that, you know, education has no value, I can't say that. I've been working 36 years. And the only time I've been without a job was for a week. Now, I did start my own engineering firm, but that was my job. So I had that for a year or so till the money went dry and I need to find a job. But guess what? I found a job just that simple. When I said I wanted another job, I got a job. Okay? So if we do the things that we're supposed to do, and provide for our families as we should. If everybody did those things, you know, we'd be so much better off, man. They need us. They don't need education. Remember, what was the one thing that they didn't want the slaves to be able to do?
Communicate, read, speak language.
Understand the language. Right. Okay, what did they keep us away from for so many years?
From those things.
Yeah. And when we were allowed to get it, what did people do?
They wanted to...
They didn't go after it.
Oh, you're saying like once we were in a position to get this...
I mean, because...
I think we were getting it, and I think maybe.
Well, see, you have to understand.
They change.
Okay.
The culture.
So many people say, wow, this stuff's too hard. I'm not going to get a job anyway. And they just quit. They just quit. I know so many people who just quit, had lucrative opportunities because they didn't want to face that challenge. And that's what's important. You have to understand, life is not going to step back out the way and let you win. You got to take your winnings. You know, most musicians, they ain't going to show you what they know. You know, and I'm using that as an analogy.
Yeah.
Okay. We two musicians. I got a few licks that I can do. You got some licks that you can do. You may can steal my licks if you're that good that you got that perfect memory. But if you ain't got that memory and I don't show you, you can't get it. But if I show you what I got and you don't show me what you got, then you know mine and yours. So I'm going off on a tangent, but I'm just trying to make a point that you got to get yours.
Yeah.
Okay? You got to. You got to get an education. We have to get educated. We have to stop this stuff of, well, there ain't no jobs out there. Okay. So what?
But just off of the numbers, like, everyone can't be educated, you know? Like, you need...
Well, we need carpenters.
Yeah.
We
need electricians. You need everybody.
Plumbers.
Yeah, you need people that's going to waste money and just piss their money away.
Well, we got a lot of them.
Yeah.
We got too many of them.
But see, that's the thing. But it's not our choice that we have all of them. It's not us as a people that they're like that. That's not the reason. It's been created. That culture is like a friend of mine, he was telling me that his girlfriend's mom has like diabetes or whatever. And she was like, you know, oh, it's going to be hard because she puts sugar in everything, you know, no matter what it is. She likes to put sugar. She likes to drink soda. She doesn't like water.
Okay, but.
But see, just check it out, though. Here she is, like a 50-year-old woman who doesn't like water, who's set in her ways, when she cooks, she puts sugar in this stuff. Think about her kids, you know, they're used to that type of stuff. Like, it's like a culture that she's passing on. And once you get to that age, like, it's going to be hard. It's hard for you to stop something. It's easy for us who haven't been raised that way to say you need to stop. But it's hard to change the way you've been raised.
But here's the thing. She's thinking about herself and not her kids. What's best for her kids. I didn't get an education, but I want the best for my kids, and I'm going to make sure they get an education.
Right, but they have an education. But now we're just saying her. Like, her and her old age is hard for her to change who she is.
But she should change for her kids, not for herself.
Right, but you can't. That's just like us saying, if it was healthy for our kids if we were gay and did homosexual prostitution,
dude.
You're not going to do it. Like, but see, that's the thing. Think about it. We are stuck in our ways of straightness. No matter what someone say to make it okay, we're still stuck. It's like, look, no, man, that's not who I am.
But we're not talking about compromising our morals, man. We're just saying do the right thing.
No, but see, that's the thing. Morals, there are no morals.
Yes, there are.
No, they're not.
There's some things you won't do. That's your set of morals.
Yes, that's my set of morals.
Yeah.
Right? But that's an illusion. There are no morals.
No, it's not an illusion.
Like, what won't I do? What won't we truly
what
do?
What won't you do? What? Tell me what you won't do.
I won't sexually assault a child.
Okay. Those are your morals.
But that's an illusion. Like, that's not real.
Yes, it is.
Like, it's really not. Part of it is based on let's go to cannibalism. I don't want to eat a person, right?
Okay.
I'm not going to eat a person.
But would you eat a rat?
No, we can get to where I'm going to eat a person. Like, there's a situation.
Yeah, you will.
Right.
But that's what I was leading up to.
Yeah.
You'll do what you have to do
you'll do what you have to do.
But there's something. But
what the culture says.
But to turn homosexual is not a life-threatening choice.
But see, that's the thing. It's a cultural. It can be a cultural thing. Greeks.
So you would do it to survive then?
No, it's not even about survival. It's just. You go to prison, it was just. No.
If you go to prison and they say, Bo, I need you to toss my salad so you can stay alive. Will you toss that salad?
It's not about life or death. What I'm saying is that it doesn't even have to be that. It doesn't even have to be that you're in prison. The Greeks show us that it wasn't even about that. It's about just the culture. If this is the culture that we were raised in, that we were a part of, then you would do it. Then you're either going to be the one getting rammed or you're going to be the one ramming. But pick.
Abraham said, God, if this team, would you spare the city? Okay.
He said,
if there's three guys, would you spare the city?
If it's 10.
Okay. So, as Christians, we do have basic morals.
Yeah, but that's as Christians. That's with the blanket of Christianity, meaning that it could be the blanket of anything.
Okay, but are you a Christian?
Yes.
Okay, so.
But that's a blanket.
Okay.
That could be changed at any moment. Like, me being a Christian, if we go 6, 7,000, 10,000 years ago, I'm not going to be a Christian. I'm going to be something else. You're going to be something else. Like, the only reason why we're Christians is because...
We can't talk about the past. All we can talk about is the here and now.
Right, but it's not a choice that you made or that I made. Like, we would be Muslims if we were somewhere else. Like, it's not a choice that we made.
Here. You are our religion, Christianity, is based off of the Jewish faith, which is based off of years of history, doing all the wrong things, and doing the wrong things are cyclical. You know, everything. There's nothing new under the sun. Everything that's been that we're trying to do now has already been done. The only thing different is we have needles now to inject drugs, but they took drugs way back when. Drugs weren't illegal. If you can make some drugs, you got paid. Okay, it wasn't until, I guess it was the 1900s, when they made marijuana illegal, because they said the black men would smoke it and go out, reefer madness, and go rape white women.
Yeah.
Now, Coca-Cola used to have actual cocaine in it. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
And the precious rich white women would take some to chill out. They'd give it to their babies. But when the black people started taking it, it became illegal. So they make those morals and things for the purpose.
But, I don't know that it was blacks that cause marijuana to become illegal.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
Well, they have a documentary.
I had to hook you up with that documentary then.
Yeah, they have another one that it's that senator, he was invested. He made a lot of money off of another product. And marijuana has an ingredient in it. And I cannot think of the name of this ingredient. But it's in a lot of stuff, and people call it, like, it'll come to me at some point. And hemp.
That's rope.
It's hemp. And,
no, hemp is a rope.
Yes, hemp.
Marijuana from a plant. Is a hemp plant.
Right.
It's the hemp plant.
Yeah.
And the one that you get high off of is the female plant. The male plant, you can't get high off of. So you only can get high off of the female plant.
Nah, the hemp, like, whatever, because they use that to make a lot of stuff.
Yeah, hemp is the rope. Hemp rope.
Rope as in like something else that man has created, or rope as in, I'm talking about just the very essence of the plant.
Well,
like an ingredient in the plant, which we could look it up.
Is that what you're talking about? The TH, the stuff that makes you high in there? Because they can extract it.
Yeah, they can extract it. But see, yeah, but it was, but it's hemp, which, you know, like I said, I mean, I could look it up, but I want to keep this going.
Okay.
But yeah, man, we'll flesh that out. But the whole idea of this documentary that I'm talking about, it shows how this guy, the main senator who was leading
What year was this?
This was, I want to say that marijuana became illegal in like the 30s. Maybe in like the 30s or
20s. It was before that.
It was like the 20s, maybe 1918 or whatever. But yeah, during that time, this guy, he was, you know, trying to just make the plant illegal so that people would not, could not use the full potential. And, you know, it would be potential. Because it would be a
full potential of marijuana, but to get you high, man.
With the hemp that's in it, you know. So it wasn't about it just being getting you high, but it's to stop all use of it so that you couldn't use anything. And in turn, I want to say he was in like the paper business or something, but I don't want it to be silent, so I'll have to pull all of that together. But yeah, man, that's what this documentary goes into.
Okay.
Tying, you know, those things together.
Do you recall?
Only because I have to keep talking, but I don't want that silent. But I'll pull it up. Like we'll get into it off of the air, and I'll go more deep into it. And for you guys that are listening,
okay, I'll read this right here. This says, to understand how we ended up here, it is important to go back to what was happening in the United States in the early 1900s, just after the Mexican Revolution. At this time, we saw an influx of immigrants from Mexico into the United States, like Texas and Louisiana. Not surprisingly, these new Americans brought with them their native language, culture, and customs. One of these customs was the use of cannabis as a medicine and relaxant. Mexican immigrants referred to the plant as marijuana. Okay. Wow. I don't need to keep reading this, man. I mean, they have to blame somebody.
Yeah, but see, that can change. Like, that's just something that someone written. But if I find mine and I read mine, it'll say what I wanted to say. Like, it doesn't matter what I read or what you read. It's just a piece of information that's out there. You feel what I'm saying?
I understand what you're saying.
The idea, the concepts will change in time. And the reasons will change. Like, a person can say,
okay, we can agree to argue. But the point that you make and the point that I make is somebody decided to make it illegal to suit their purpose. Okay? To say that they made it illegal because they want to control the Mexicans and the blacks, or to say they made it illegal because one guy wanted to corner the market on his product. It's basically saying the same thing. They did it for a control purpose, you know, not for the betterment of the population, but so somebody can make money off of it. Okay.
Yeah, and as time moves along, we gain a deeper insight of a situation, of a problem. So, you know, if we just look at face value of something and we say, okay, this happened because of this, and as we get more and more information and we start to really look at the person, we can say, okay, here is what truly led to their motives. Now, you know, like you said, I mean, it's all about issues, really about money and control.
Okay, here's one for you. What state are we in right now?
West Virginia.
Okay. West Virginia used to be called Western Virginia, the western part of Virginia, okay? During the Civil War, you know, oil was discovered in West Virginia first and foremost. Oil was discovered here before Texas, every place else. Then they found some in Pennsylvania, but it was first discovered here, okay? So, right at the Civil War, they was making buku money because they used to get their oils by going out and killing whales. So now, all we got to do is drill for it. We got natural gas, salt water, and oil out of those wells. So the powers that be, they were making millions of dollars back then. They decided, well, what is strategically best for us? Our loyalties to the South or our profits. So they decided we're going to secede from Virginia. And we're going to create a new state called West Virginia. And we're going to side with the North. And the way they cut the state up was they made sure that their oil wells were in West Virginia and the railroad, a particular railroad. So we're talking about 10, 15 millionaires got together and decided the fate of this entire state. So again, it boils back down to somebody's profiting off of the masses. That's what it's all about, man. It's about the profiting. If you look throughout history, every war, every conflict was over money, gold, profit, some kind of power trip. Okay, that's what it's all about, man. First place they go to when they conquer a country is to the banks, whatever you want to call what their banks were, and the libraries. They want your money and your knowledge. And then they're done with you. So, but yeah, man, that's how West Virginia got started. It tripped me out.
Oh, man, I was listening to NPR, and they were talking about how this one Iranian or just Middle Eastern guy, he was saying how Saudi Arabia is the cause of all of the problems, like America. The problem is that America is trying to fight Saudi Arabia's wars. You know, like Saudi Arabia has America fighting all of its wars.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, they back these small terrorist groups, so-called terrorist groups.
Yeah.
They're backing them. And so it's like, it's just one hand, they're just clapping, you know, because on one hand they have America, on the other hand they have these groups, and they just like, you know.
Well, the Bushes were so deep in bed with Saudi Arabia. And you got to remember, though, now, 15 of the terrorists who flew in 9/11 were from Saudi Arabia. So, I mean, what can you say, man? You know, you lay down with dogs, you're going to get fleas.
Yeah.
And I'm not calling them dogs, but I'm just saying, you know, that's just an analogy. That's what you're going to get.
Yeah, I mean, it's just crazy. Like, I never really looked at it like that, you know, and it's like, man, it is crazy because America continues to get this bad rep in the Middle East, you know, and it's like we're just the gophers for the Saudis.
Well, you and I are, but the powers that be is making money.
Right, right, yeah.
Okay. And the bottom line is our national interest. Okay, how's that interest me to go over to Afghanistan, that dusty, dirty little place where nothing grows but poppy? How is that helping me? You know, how? Are you casting on that too?
No.
Oh,
no.
You just checking time?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. You confused me for a second. I'm like, dude, what you doing, man?
Yeah, man. Now, I was going to cast on here. I was going to Periscope, but
nah.
It was just, which that would have been better, but it's hard, you know, to just hold the phone to really get both of us in there.
But I mean, any news that you get is a form of propaganda. So you have to look through all of it, weigh it. What do you believe? What do you think? And the one common factor in every conflict is, okay, for example, Vietnam. You know, Vietnam was a colony and was controlled by the French prior to World War II. And they got kicked out of there. And so they tried to reclaim it after the war. Okay? Because when the Germans conquered France, they took everything from them. All their holdings, they had to give up the funk. So at the end of World War II, the French tried, and the reason the French were over there was because of the rubber trees. Okay? Vietnam was strategic because it had rubber trees. And prior to the outer polymers that they used to make rubber now, they used to make tires from rubber trees. Okay? So it was once upon a time strategic. You have to ask yourself, why are we in these dirty little towns? These dirty little, and I'm not saying they're dirty. I'm just saying they have no value to you, Bo Miles, or me, Fiddle. So why are we over there fighting? It's because somebody was making money. So once they came up with another way to make tires, which was in the late 50s, it wasn't strategic anymore. So we're over there. The French got their butts kicked. Okay, the French got their asses kicked. I mean, really. They capitulated to the Germans, and the Vietnamese kicked their ass. So we go over there under Truman to help the French reclaim their colony. Okay? They lost it. You keep what you kill.
Yeah, he said, look, man.
You keep what you kill. I mean, they took it back. So, but we went over there, and some kind of way, I forget exactly how, they split the North and the South up. And they had these two brothers over there, the Ming brothers. And they were playing both sides. Let me say that. They were playing both sides. So they got assassinated.
And was this North and South? Did they have a North and South?
Yeah, they had a North and South Vietnam. And we fought with the South Vietnam. Okay. And North, you have to think. All these Northern, like North Korea, South Korea, North Vietnam, South Vietnam, they're all close. The North is close to communist China. That's why we were fighting them. Okay? They claim, okay, we have to keep communism from spreading. Okay. They went communist anyway. So how did it affect us? But anyway, the Mann brothers got assassinated. Okay? Kennedy sanctioned it, supposedly. Within 3 months, he was dead. So that's how Malcolm X got in trouble. Because back then, they were going around sanctioning every fucking body, man. They was killing all kind of political leaders because they wanted to make sure nobody went communist. So, I mean, you got to look at your history, but then you have to look at the history and understand why was this history. What was the strategic interest? When the Romans were in Bethlehem in Israel, why were they there? You know, when Jesus was born, the Romans were there. Why were they there? What strategic interest did Israel, the Nazarites have? Why did they have to go back and do a census? Why did they have to pay a tax? Because they was pimping. The Romans was pimping, man. You know, it wasn't because we're going to make life better for you. No, we want your money, man. That's what it's all about. Ducks.
Yeah, man. It makes me think of back when I was coming up in our gangs and how, like, we never developed to a level where people were paying taxes to us.
That's because y'all never pressed them to. You didn't know about it.
Right, right. We didn't think about. But eventually
you would have been.
Right. Like, we never thought about, you know, making the small, like, making the other gangs pay a tax. And I don't think, even now, I don't think drug dealers do that. You know, like, look.
No, they pay the leader.
Pay tax.
They pay the leader.
Right, right. You pay the leader, but, you know.
But again, you have to remember, though, back in the 30s and 40s, the same system is in place as it is now. They fought each other for control of certain areas. And the only way they stopped was they organized into one big group. Okay. You run the south side, I run the north side, he runs the east side, and you run the west side. We agree to stay out of each other's turf. You can't kill nobody unless you come to us and ask for permission to kill somebody. That's how they stopped it.
Yeah, and that's like your Italian type gangs or?
Well, Crips and Bloods could do that too if they so chose to.
Right, but see, like we don't do that. You know, like you figure, like we don't have that type of organization to our gangs. It's just.
Well, they didn't either at first. You have to develop it. You have to understand what's going on. Okay, it's so many crackheads out there. Till it's enough. If they wasn't so selfish, and I'm gonna tell you, I'm not advocating the sale of drugs in any way, shape, or form. But okay, say it was a legitimate business. Can you go out and kill your competition for for selling tennis shoes that you're trying to sell? Yeah. You can't do that. Okay, you have to make your product that much better than the other person's till they're gonna want to buy yours, and that's what they do. But nah, man, you can't run out and steal his tennis shoes from him and then sell them.
Man, have you seen The Wire? Have you seen that series? No. Oh, man, that's an HBO series.
I don't have HBO. You hit me to it, man. Hit me to it.
Yeah. Oh, man, I think I have it on. Yeah, I have it for you to watch, so I'll.
Okay. Let's see if it's on Netflix.
Nah. HBO, they separated their partnership with Netflix a long time ago so that they could do their own thing, HBO Go and HBO Now. But yeah, man, I'll hook you up because that's a really good show. I wonder if it's, nah, they probably, which they should. I mean, they should put their old shows on Netflix like HBO Now and stuff like that, man. They really should do
that. Well, I see. What I see in the future is, mm-hmm. actually, The Wire season one is on Amazon, man.
All right, y'all, oh, man. Do you have it?
Yeah, I'm looking at it right here, man.
Yeah. Oh man, yeah. Watch it, man. Cause that first season. That first season was really good. Man.
I got 5 seasons of it.
Yeah, I think that's all it was 5 maybe, 5. Well,
but what I think is gonna happen, and I'm just speculating, is that. In the next 10 or 15 years, you're going to even need a cable box. You're going to have to, all you need is internet, and you cut your deals with whoever you want to cut them with. So, like, if I want HBO, and if I want Showtime, and I don't want that other stuff, I don't have to have it.
Right.
You know? Because I can, just like I can get Netflix and Amazon, I got both of them, man.
Right, and they have,
That's the future, man.
Hulu, like so you can get.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that's the future.
Yeah, yeah, I agree with you.
And we got to get a piece of that rock, man.
He said, look, man, that thing is growing.
Yeah, man, we gotta get on there, man.
Yeah, at the content train. I'm trying to think of what this may be. I don't know. Cause I think I'm logged in to so many different things, man. That's the thing with this new age and all of these passwords is like.
You got to get you one or two strong passwords, and
yeah, I try to.
What's your password, man?
I try to keep them on the
P at. S-S-W-O-R-D.
Yeah. P-U-S-S-Y.
No.
Juicy.
No.
Juicy pussy. That's my password.
Ooh. Somebody go try that.
I know. Don't worry. It's not going to kill them no way.
Somebody going to use it for themselves.
Yeah.
Like, look. I'll never forget that one.
He said,
I just have problems remembering my password. I should come up with something intelligent. Okay. How about juicy pussy?
Yeah, you can't go wrong with that. You just can't. Look, juicy pussy. But yeah,
P man, capital you, U.
Yeah.
S capital S Y.
Every other word, every other letter is caps.
Yeah.
He said, look.
It works.
You can't beat it.
Can't beat it. You'll never forget it.
Ooh. Or wet, wet, wet. Wet, wet, 007, wet, wet.
What's app? What's app?
What's app? What's app?
What's app?
Yeah, man. Like, Yeah, but The Wire, man, that's a good show.
I'm going to try it out, man.
Yeah, it deals with people in Baltimore, like just a drug.
Oh, the homies and stuff?
Yeah, yeah, man. Give you a good look at how, you know.
Okay,
how,
well, I'm going to have to, you know, when I make them long junkets up to Cleveland.
Yeah.
I can do a season, two or three seasons.
Yeah, man. You definitely going to get an idea of how I was growing up as a young tyke. Of course,
okay. No, the drugs. No wonder you like it.
Of course, the drugs wasn't as prevalent in my, you know, during my time. Because we were doing just a lot of fighting. But we didn't sell drugs, like, just my immediate group, North and Bond. I remember when we finally did come across, like, cocaine. Well, the big homie, our number one, you know, fighter. Mm-hmm. He, somehow, some way, he came across some. I don't know if he just beat somebody up and took it from him or what. But he had, like, a small pack, you know. Like, it wasn't nothing, man. He probably had, like, 3 or 4 Nicks or something. Wow. And
probably was Babsalt or some shit.
Like yeah, man. Who knows, man? Like, you know, like we just wasn't into drugs. And so we had that. But then after
that's that. Thing.
Yeah.
Because you'd probably be dead right now if it was.
Well, yeah, man. Eventually the gang, they all got into it. Now, see, when I was probably like 14, we got evicted.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It was on my birthday. Like, okay. Yo, happy birthday, Bo. Get the fuck out of here. You know, and. Yeah, just dumped all my stuff out in the street. And
wow.
So, yeah. So, you know, I got evicted. But at that same time, then I moved with my aunt who lived away from where I grew up at. Now, okay. At that time, the neighborhood drug dealer, the kingpin in the neighborhood, he just started picking up all the homies, you know. Because we used to hang with his nephew.
Mm-hmm.
And they all lived in the same house. So we knew him, okay. You know. His name was Bill. I don't know if he's alive or not, but it don't matter at this point.
Did he put y'all out there?
So he eventually, you know, had everybody working for him, like all the people in the neighborhood.
Mm.
He had them working for him, but I was already gone. So,
yeah, well, that's good.
So yeah, I dodged that one.
Sometimes, you know, if you had not been kicked to the curb, you'd be still there doing what you wouldn't be Bo.
Right, right, man. Yeah, I'll be Bo in prison or Bo dead or,
oh well,
you know, who knows? But man, it's, you know.
Yeah, well, things happen for a reason. And, you know, I had to tell my daughter that, you know, when God closes the door, he doesn't plan for you to go in that direction anymore. The mistake we make is we try to go through that door. If we would be patient and turn around and look in another direction, there are other doors that have opened up for you. So, you know, everything that seems bad isn't always bad. You know, like, well, you lose a family member, that's bad. That's really hard to recover from. But you know, you don't get a particular job or a woman leaves you or you leave a woman. That might be the best thing in the world for her. You take your non-working ass away. And I'm not talking about you.
I was a non-working son of a bitch.
No, you working. You work 3 job, man. You got 3 job, man.
Yeah. You know, I stay working.
Yeah, man.
But nah, man, you're right, though. I mean, you figure because even that, if you look at that, you know, like, that door was closed, you know, like, we got put out. And so then I went with one of the homies, you know, and one of my other homies, he got put out with me. So both of us got put out. He got put out his home, I got put out. So we was just trying to find somewhere to stay.
What you do, man?
And so, you know, we went to one of the big homies' houses.
You evaded my question. What did you do to get kicked out?
Oh, just not paying the rent. Like, I was a kid. Like,
oh, your parents?
Yeah, like 14.
Oh, I thought you were talking about you.
Oh, nah.
So, man. Was he living with you or?
No, his family got put out. You feel me? Like,
oh, the landlord
evicted.
Just,
yeah.
The landlord was just cleaning the house that day.
Well, hey, you're not paying the rent for several months or however many months. Look, it's time to go. So, wow. So yeah, man, we got evicted, you know? And his family, you know, got evicted. My family got evicted. And now my dad had already left, so it was just me and my mom. And then, you know, I went to go stay with him for a little bit. Now, he lived in the neighborhood. He only lived, like, up the street. And then I don't know if he was on cocaine or what, man. but I think, you know, like, I was kind of getting in the way of his rendezvous. So he was like, he found my aunt and called her up, like, yo.
Come get this little nephew.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, yo, man, I'm trying to get this coke right, you know. And so he, you know, got me down. So then I moved out of the neighborhood. Mm-hmm. Now my friend who got evicted along with my family getting evicted, he stayed in the neighborhood. And eventually he started, you know, hustling for the neighborhood kingpin.
Everybody's hustling, yeah. hustling.
And one of the close homies shot him in his chest. Like, I don't even know. I forgot what they even said it was over, you know.
Turf for money or disrespect?
Yeah, it's probably like something like that. Yeah, shot him, like, you know, like, man.
I mean, it wasn't nothing because he liked him. So,
like, yo, that's crazy, man. I mean, just, it's like, yo, these dudes really not your friend. You feel me? Like,
no.
And you really think they are, man, but they not, man.
What they say, keep your friends close and your enemies closer.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. James 3:16, where envy and strife is, there's confusion and every evil at work.
Yeah, and man, and the dude who shot him, like, yo, he's not even in jail. Like, he just living like a regular life, you know?
I mean, they never said why he shot him, he just...
Yeah, they said it was like I said, it was like out of respect or over something stupid.
Like, he shorted him 50 cents. No, you know. Owe me 50 cents, man. I want my money.
Yeah,
it's
like,
the principality of the thing, man.
Yeah, like, yo. You feel me? Like, people like that, like, I just don't even want to see, like, I don't want to see him, you know? Like, and I want to say, like, one of my people was like, yo, you know, dude was asking about you. Like, yo, man, don't ask about me, man. Like, don't ask about me, dog, because I ain't going to forget that. Like, yo, you shot one of the homies over something stupid, like, yo. And you figure, like, yo, he can clean his life up. You feel me? Like, he not in that game. He live working just a regular job.
What they say, man, revenge is dish best served cold, man.
Like,
you know, right when he's starting to really enjoy life, it's going to come back at him, man. It's going to come back at him.
Yeah, man. But, yeah, it was, like, that's just crazy. You feel me? That's like me shooting you. Like, they were close. You feel like it's really baffling, you know, but they got caught up in it and...
Shoot, guys will shoot you because they think you mess with their woman.
Yeah, I mean, well, I understand that. I can understand
no,
that.
No, I couldn't.
But...
I can't because, oh, girl, she's supposed to know her place with you.
Right, man, but if you thought I was messing with your woman, like, you
well,
just not
no,
going
I'll
just...
Well, no, I'll back off, man. Look,
you're
I'm
not going just...
Joe, Bo, you miss one bus, you catch the next one. I mean, we ain't friends no more. We ain't friends no more, but think about it, man. You ain't tying her down. You know?
Yeah.
You ain't tying her down. If she wants to give it up to you and she disrespects me that much, I don't need that in my life, man.
Right, right.
You got to move on, bro.
Yeah. I mean, I don't feel like, you know, I feel like I could be civil in a some type of domestic, you know, girlfriend situation.
I'm gonna tell you. Those emotions over, see, you haven't had that happen really bad to you in your life, but man, them some deep emotions, man. To you know, you've invested your life with someone, and
man, my first wife. Like, look, man,
but that was mutual. You know, y'all kind of mutually just separated. You know,
but I didn't want it. Like, I didn't want her to go and, you know, her out just stripping and just living a crazy life. Like, it was affecting me, you know, like I was.
But it wasn't good for you, man.
Right.
It wasn't good for you. It wasn't healthy.
No, it wasn't. Man.
You know, we can't be in unhealthy situations and survive as men. Because no man wants to know his woman is taking her clothes off for other men.
Right.
You know, that just don't work. You know, I saw this one video on Facebook where this brother got all his buddies over his house. You know, they making a bunch of noise. And they'll go come in and tell, y'all gotta shut up all that noise. And they said, I'll get out of here. She said, okay. So she went to the bedroom, took all her clothes off, came walking in the living room in her panties, bent over, went in the refrigerator. Everybody started looking at her. The dude went crazy, pulled out his gun and started shooting. But y'all got to get out of here. I mean, you know, emotions over your woman is a serious thing, man. It takes real control to understand. And, you know, if I kill everybody who look at my woman, it's not everybody else. What's my woman doing to want them to draw them to look at her? Right. And she can say, well, I'm not doing nothing. I can't control how other people feel. Yes, you can. You can carry yourself in a manner that, you know, they know you with somebody.
But see, that goes back to women living in this illusion. Like, look, every guy want to smash. But that's not their reality. Like, they don't believe that, but that is the true reality. And if you give an inch, they're going to take a mile. Like,
You know what? I'm with my wife. Can't no other woman walk up on me and throw it at me and think I'm going to walk away from my wife, man. They can't.
He said, don't even try that.
I'll tell them, I'm not interested.
Right. Keep that fat ass over there. You know?
I'm not interested.
Keep them juicy nipples over there. I'm not trying to suck with them things now.
What's this all about? Why are you interested in me? You don't even know me. You know?
Yeah. Oh, man, that reminds me of the time in high school.
I might be some axe murderer.
I was messing with this girl. I really liked her, too, man. Like, I tried to friend her on Facebook. She didn't accept my request. And so I was messing with her. And then this other girl, she was throwing it at me.
Oh.
So I was trying to take it. Like, look, well, you know, you're going to give it up. So it was a half a day. We go over to our house. I'm trying to smash the whole time. Mm-hmm. You know, she not letting me smash, right? She not letting me smash. She not letting me smash. So I leave. I probably leave probably like, so like I said, half a day. So I got there maybe about 12.
You put your work in for 8 hours.
Right, 8 hours with no smashing at all.
Okay, did you go back?
So she tells my girl.
That you was trying to smash.
No, that I did. She told my girl that I did smash. So needless to say, that was no longer my girl. And man, she just cut me off. She never talked to me again after that, man. I was so just heated because I tried to smash.
You got blamed and didn't get the benefits of it.
Right. Right. And wow. I told her, I was like, yo, I didn't touch her. I didn't have sex with her. She was like, yes, you did. She was like, why would she lie? I was like, look, I tried. I was trying, but I didn't. You know, like, look, I was trying to smash.
Well, just the mere fact that you tried, I'm done with you.
Nah, she believed that I hit. Like, so the girl, she just used me, I guess, to get to her.
To hurt her.
Yeah.
She was jealous of her.
Yeah, man. That was crazy.
James 3:16, man.
Yeah, man. So, you know. And like I said, like, it still messed with her because, like, some of my old girlfriends, I friend them and it's all good. Like, they friends with me, but nah, not her.
Like, you must have really broke her heart, man.
Yeah.
She had plans for your ass.
Yeah, man. I had plans for her, man. Like, that's, like, I would, that's my girl. Like, even now, forever. I know she's listening to this podcast. She's...
Well, you have to decide what's important for you, man.
You know, man.
You know, here.
I didn't hit.
You know, I've never cheated on a woman I was committed to. You know, I've never cheated on a girlfriend that I had a committed relationship with. And I never cheated on a wife. Once you walked out the door, you wasn't my wife no more. All deal was off. It was a whole different... Because you got up and walked out on your own. But I always felt that, you know, that when you cheat and you have a family, you're not just cheating on your wife. You're cheating on your child, too. Because your child needs all of your attention, you know, all of your loving and nurturing. And if you out making babies with another lady, how can you be fully nurturing in that committed relationship? Okay, who's supposed to get it? The first ones or the second ones? You know, that's what all I'm saying. You know, like, but if old girl decides she wants to break on you and you decide to go out and make another family, that's a whole horse of a different color, man.
Say, look, two families.
You know, went to a couple of funerals. Fight broke out because his other family showed up to the funeral, too. Who that? He looked like daddy.
Oh, man. I know a couple people like that who, you know, their dad or granddad had like a couple families or whatever.
I know some preachers who had a couple families.
So, yeah. Look, all man. Was a roll yeah, of stone. Look. I mean, a lot of those prophets.
Wherever he laid his hat was his home.
Had and issues.
When he died, so they like, all look, he left
this was alone.
I'm trying to give up the magic stick.
He's looking out for him. But here, you know, that seems cool for a man to do that, but it really isn't. It's destructive, man.
Right, it is.
It's destructive to family.
And it's very primitive, you know, very chimp-like.
Just yeah. Well, you know, chimp-like, well, you know what? When everything else fails, your reason and logic, that libido still's there. You still want to get your rocks off. You know
get
what I'm saying?
Cock wet.
Well, yeah. But I don't know, man. It's wild.
Yeah, man. Oh, man. Before we wrap this up, man, we at least gotta give something more. MLK. This is his day, man.
Oh yeah, man.
But
he sacrificed for us, and we have to ask ourselves if he knew we were gonna act like this and be the state we are right now. You think he would have put himself in a position to sacrifice his life like this for us?
Yeah, man. He was smashing and doing all kinds of crazy stuff. So, you know, he knew, like, yo, everybody not perfect, but at least give us a chance. You know, look, I'm going to smash the chicks, but give me a chance to smash these chicks. You know, he's going to do the right thing. Give him a chance to do the right thing. Just don't just shut the door because of the color of my skin. You know, when we go on back page, like, look, I'm not trying to see no African-Americans, you know? Nah, no black men. No black men can get this coochie. Like, wow.
We want the right to hit it, too.
Oh, boy. Yeah, but, you know, yeah, man. He was, because like I said, man, he was out there, so he knew, like, look.
Well, they had an FBI file on him. And they had one on Malcolm X too, and they said Malcolm X was like a saint next to Martin Luther King.
Yeah, oh man, I interviewed this woman. She was like an elder of a church. Mm-hmm. She was talking about Martin Luther King. She didn't say like you know she sucked his dick or anything, but she was just saying how she got a chance to meet him. They went up, met him up in Cleveland. I guess he was doing some rallying work up there, so. Mm-hmm. I think she probably jumped on it, but she ain't want to say it.
Mm.
And
she was respectable, now.
Right. She was just trying to keep it clean, you know, keep that MLK dream alive, you know.
Like little Martin's running around, huh?
Yeah, but yeah, man, I know she rolled that.
You know, and I hate to say this, and I hate to throw fuckery around. But there were some people who there were if you Google on not even Google, if you go to YouTube, they're saying that Jesse Jackson was involved.
Oh, in the murder?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yeah. So check it out.
Yeah, man. I mean, cuz you figure, you know,
there was the one guy
people that's close to you like that. They are the ones. Because the FBI come after, they come up to him. You know they went up to him. Hey, JJ.
We know what you're doing.
Right.
And quite as kept being my frat brother, so.
Yeah. They going to be like, yo, man, you next in line. You know, let's go ahead.
But he wasn't. He was third in line. And he wasn't. He wasn't even. If you look at the last time he talked, he started shunning Jesse Jackson away from him.
Oh,
you gotta just when you get
there. Yeah.
Look it up, man, on Facebook.
Yeah, I will, man.
I'm not on Facebook, but YouTube.
Yeah, on the tube. Yeah, man, I'm gonna check that out. I was watching.
And these are. Dick Gregory even said it.
Yeah, they're like, yo, man, JJ yeah. has something to do with this.
Yeah.
But see, that's the thing, because if you look at the Black Panther one, you know, it's always an inside job, man. They always, because our loyalty is so thin, like, it's ridiculous.
Well, nobody can get to you but somebody you know. Yeah. You know, the only people that can get you is the ones who are actually close to you, man.
Right, man. I mean, it's ridiculous that even JJ would even be a part of that, but yeah, I wouldn't put it past him.
Well, you know, people get starstruck, man. They want that power and, like, okay, remember when Obama first came out? Jesse Jackson said, you ain't gonna be president. You gotta go through me to get to the presidency. What? Who are you?
Right. I remember something like that.
Yeah.
And then he was crying the day when...
Because he had no control. See, what the deal was, I guess he thought his son was going to be president. And then they started busting his son out for drugs and alcohol and women and all that kind of stuff.
But you got to know that they come. You got to be clean on that. Like, you can't.
Well, they busted out Jesse Jackson for having illegal children, illegitimate children too, man.
I remember that. Yeah. Like, I remember that. Yeah, I was a kid when that was popped off.
You know, you have to. If you preaching, you have to stay clean, man. You know, because there ain't no secrets. Once they see you poking your head up, they checking you out.
Right, they coming. The wolves are coming.
They coming at you hardcore. So all y'all future leaders out there, y'all better keep it clean.
Right.
Or kill the motherfuckers that do the witnesses. You know?
I wonder if we elapsed in time. Who knows? It doesn't matter.
I mean, we still on, so.
Right. But yeah, man. But that's crazy. Like, that's crazy. Like, once you decide that you want to be a leader, like, you have to look at your past and make sure that it's clean. Make sure.
Well, there's this one guy named Omar Johnson. He's been on YouTube doing talks and stuff. And
yeah, I think I know him.
People been slandering him because he out chasing butt. Well, he ain't married. He made the mistake of saying he wants to save himself for when he get married, instead of saying, I haven't found myself a queen yet, but I'm searching. As opposed to saying, I'm going to remain a celibate until I find, and he out chasing butt. So he discredited himself that way. His word, his message and his words are still valid and powerful, but people look at that little stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay. He contradicted himself as opposed to, well, you know, I'm a man. And the king has to find himself a proper queen. You know, and if she don't measure up.
Yeah, but a king got to have several sluts. Like, that's what people got to understand. Like, I hate when they do the lion analogy. Like, women will be like, they'll be like, I want a king who's worthy enough for me to be their queen and la la la. And they'll post pictures of lions, right? A lion has several bitches hunting for him. Like, he just doesn't have
They call him lionesses, man.
Like, he just doesn't have one.
He has a pride.
Yeah, he has a pride. Harold, hook bitch, get out there and bring that money back to Easel.
Well, instead of money, bring that gazelle back.
Right. Get out. Yeah.
The land, the male lions don't do the hunting.
Right, they don't.
Look. It's the females.
Right.
Get your ass out there. What's wrong with you?
Go. Y'all four of y'all run out there, and then after y'all done, I'm going to smash each one of y'all.
I'm going to treat you. I'm going to reward you.
And this lion cock, you know? But like, people, they post pictures of a lion. It's like, what are you doing? Do you not know?
No, they don't know.
They're like, oh, I want a lion. Like, all right, well, gather up three more bitches and I'll be your lion.
Wow. I'll be your king.
Yeah, I'll be your king. I'll be your lion king. But yeah, man, it's that's crazy. But that's what a king, throughout history, a king always has several hoes.
Well, even mistresses. Even biblical, they had more than one wife. You know, when you're nation building, even when they started in Salt Lake City, Utah, polygamy was allowed, and the reason it was allowed was they wanted to build a separate nation of people. You know, guy had five or six wives. It wasn't just for him to have fun. You gotta make some kids. You gotta bring some people into this world so we can have us a whole state. But, well, you know, they was trying to build a country, but it turned out to be a state, which is basically the same thing. They went out there for religious freedom. You know, they want to have all the women that they want, and that's what happened, man.
This is live. Okay. Synced up, but we'll call it on this on the stream.
Okay.
We'll, you know, pick it back
keep
up.
Keep rolling.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
because the sound is still popping, even though we don't have the thing on, and I think that's probably what was the problem, is that it was listening to the sound and playing the sound at the same time and observing itself, and that's what created that feedback.
Okay, so we probably lost all of that then.
No. Like when we were listening to that. But, like, since I've turned it down, I don't think we caught any of that feedback in there. But, yeah, man, it'll be all right. I mean,
it was a good experience.
Our first, stream, and we'll do better.
Next time.
Yeah, guys. Peace. So, those of you who are on the live stream, this is down over. Oh, our listeners, we'll be doing this Mondays at around 6-ish. You know, CPT, baby. So next Monday,
look for us about 6:30.
Right, next Monday 6:30, we're gonna be back, and eventually we'll, you know, be doing this the whole time, the whole 2-3 whatever, however long we take on these joints.
Yeah,
but that's it. We're out for the live stream.
Peace.
All right. So yeah, guys. Now everybody else who
now we can get dirty, get down and dirty. That's a unique experience for me, man. I mean, millions of people can see me.
Yeah. Yeah. Come after you.
Millions. Wow.
It will save. I don't know. My document. Yeah, we'll just save it.
But yeah, it's mind-boggling when you think that all the major events that have altered the world, someone profited from it. Someone made money from it. Or someone did it so they can make money from it. Like the one guy, he cornered the market on silver. And he pulled all the silver in. He bought up all the silver. Okay? He had like 60% of the silver in his control. And everybody started going crazy trying to get silver. The price of silver shot up. Then he dumped all his back on the market. And they do that stuff just to see what'll happen, man. Just to see what'll happen. Just for the fun of it, man. We like puppets to them. We like aphids. How can I make money off of them? And you know, that's the reason why the South was so mad at us, because they had invested so much money in us. We were a commodity. And they never got reimbursed for us.
Right.
You gonna reimburse me for that? Remember the Django? How the one guy?
He said you gonna reimburse me for that nigga.
You was supposed to fight five fights. I only got three fights out of you. Well, you owe me $5,000. Who gonna reimburse me for this nigga? So that's why they're so angry at us. They didn't get reimbursed for their losses. So we money on the hoof, and they didn't get paid. Man, just think. The interest on the niggas. Everyone that my slave owned, every slave I owned, just imagine. all the little niggers that they had and how much money I could have made off of all them niggers. Man, oh man, I am mad. I'm going to get everyone I can see, I'm going to kill.
He said, where's my return?
Yeah, where's my reimbursement? You going to reimburse me? Where's my reparation?
Who's going to reimburse me for these niggas?
Yep. Yeah. Well, he's just a commodity to him. It's about money, man.
Yeah, oh, man. But like I was saying on that site, it was a white guy who said that he was talking about, you know, he was just having fun thinking about the slavery days. And he was, because this video was showing, like, a black girl sucking a white boy off. And he was like, yeah, you know, that's what we used to call sex education. We just, the master just bring a black girl out and just let his sons go to town, like teaching them the ways. Like, look, man, this is what you got to do. And it wasn't, he was like, man, it wasn't called rape. It was just called sex education.
Okay, and you still think they got that right, huh?
But that was my point. They love those movies and those stories just to relive. Like, even if that guy who wrote that was probably like 20 or 30.
But you know,
never experienced it, but he knows. You see, it was passed down.
Well, you ever hear dark oak or black oak?
Yeah.
Well, that's what they say, you know, a white boy ain't a man until he had a black woman.
Right.
So that's why they feel so comfortable in disrespecting our women.
Yeah.
Yeah, do you have Amazon, man?
Like the Prime or whatever?
Yeah.
No, I don't have Amazon Prime.
Well, the reason I got Prime, you get Amazon, you get Prime for free. Okay? And the reason I carry Amazon, do all my shopping on Amazon is I get all the stuff I need.
Yeah.
And if I spent as much money on my gas as I do buying stuff, I couldn't do my shopping, man. Because, you know, that's half the price. People don't understand that, you know, getting stuff through the mail is cheaper than burning up gas.
Right. I mean, because the other company, is burning up the gas, not you.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, that's like, what, $90 to $100 a year? So less than $10 a month?
Yeah, depending on how much you buy, and most things we buy is over $35, that's free shipping. You know, you got to check out Amazon, man. They have like this thing. I did this once. My daughter's in college, and I sent her a care package, man. I bought a lot of stuff, put it in this box, and sent it to her. Free shipping. You know, $100 worth of stuff, free shipping. Stuff she needed. Check it out, bro.
Yeah, man. I do have like the Fire Stick. I do have Amazon, and I have a good piano course on there. It's really good, man. That's some good stuff. So yeah, I am familiar with it. I just I haven't gotten their streaming service where you can get TV shows. And
it's free, man. If you got Amazon, if you're a Prime member,
mm-hmm.
you got
all of that stuff is free.
It's free, man. It's free with it. Did you check out this thing I sent you, man, from the lady laying with her, what's her name? Come on up. This one right there.
No, I don't think I saw that one. When did you send it? Recently?
Yesterday.
No, I didn't. Sunday? Yeah, sure. They look all right.
You know who that is, don't you, man?
Oh, Marilyn Monroe? Kim K?
Mm-mm. Betty White.
Oh,
from back in the day.
New message request.
Young, man.
Let's see, who is this? Somebody sent me a message. Let's see. 9:30 a.m. She sent me a message. It's no longer available because it was identified as abusive or marked as spam.
What? Yeah. Who sent it to you?
Let's see this chick. Let's go to her profile, see if it's still there. Man, a lot of these,
was it Betty White
or like Iraqi guys, Pakistanians, they create these. Yeah, she's not there no more. So,
okay, how about the little midget women?
Oh, yeah, I saw that one. So, yeah, man, a lot of times, man, they get flagged or whatever. They create these accounts, you know, such and such, whatever. You feel me? And they're not even real. So, a lot of these guys, they like to, I saw that
one. Would you do one?
All of them. Man, I love me some little people, dog. Oh, man, I wish some of them lived in my town. When I was on the market, man, because I would have definitely scooped me up some of them in more than one way.
For moral or immoral purposes?
Both. I would have been just getting it in. Yeah, dog. Yeah, I like me some little people.
I can't say nothing bad about them.
Oh, man, I love them. Yeah. So let me see.
Oh, did you,
Let's see this woman.
It's that one with the brother with the martial arts. Did you ever make that thing, man?
Oh, nah. Hey, let me do it now.
Huh?
I said, let me do it now.
What? I don't have no jump drive with me, man.
Oh, at least I'll have it. You feel me? Her name is Margaret Burns. See that picture? She look all right, but
who?
This one, the one that you sent.
Yeah, but that's not Margaret Burns. That's Betty White from Golden Girls.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
But yeah, man, like this picture, you just never know what it really looked like when she.
I'm not gonna send you nothing that they gonna say is inappropriate.
Right.
I'm not gonna send you no beheading stuff.
Said beheadings.
That's what the Arabs was probably doing, man. I don't play that crap, man. I watched this one. I'm still disturbed by it, man. And I watched it over a year ago. It disturbed me to the point.
One of those beheadings?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was on YouTube. That's the sad thing. They must have got it off real quick. But it took this guy up in the bushes. It was clandestine. It wasn't even organized. It was like three guys. One guy reading the paper, one guy filming, and one guy doing the cutting. I mean, that's barbaric, man. I mean,
Yeah. Man, the worst, man, like those Mexican cartels, when they behead people, man. Oh, no. I tell you, man. Like,
they be doing that, too?
Yeah, man, they do that a lot. Like, there was a site, man, I can't even remember it right now, But man. It was just vicious, you know. It's vicious, I can tell you that, man.
No, I don't wanna see it, man. It messed me up, man.
It messed me up for like a year.
I don't wanna see it, man. I mean really.
So
'cause it
yeah, stuff like that, man. And I just can't imagine being present. Like, for that.
You got to be high to do that kind of stuff, man.
I hear you, boy. A couple videos. Here, man, let's check this out. We know this one, right? This is the one that we...
Yeah, I got that one. I seen that one.
You want this?
Yes, sir.
Horse. All right, so we got that. You know, let's check them out. Oh, we got to see him in competition.
Oh.
Because like Bruce Lee said, boards don't hit back.
And students don't either.
Yeah. Yeah, dude. I mean.
Damn.
Go ahead. Is it jujitsu? All right. So he's giving that. Let's listen to this.
Your arm has been hyperextended. Maybe it's been pushed out to the extreme.
Yeah, it's not up where we would like it to be, but it's
a person putting their hips on the floor, they're laying on the ground.
But you can enhance it though, that section.
They're not in the true armbar, in the armbar position. So I want to see if he's going to get into the real position. He's letting him. He can use his legs to control his body. So.
It's very hard for me to pull my hand back here. All right. What I want to do is turn my elbow so that it's to the side. This will help me. And if I can't move it right away, I can do a whole lot more by running this here. This will also give me my vertical fist to shoot straight at his face. Remember, he's stopping me from trying to pull it up because he's pulling my hand up. So
I think if you went vertical first and then turned it, it'd be more effective than trying to turn it. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't expect it to come up into your chin hard.
Pull it back down. So, and I'll know it from this belt, it'll scrape across here and push down here and push up.
But that's,
once I'm pushing up, he can still hold on. It doesn't mean that he's going
to
let go.
That's an illegal move to put his elbow on the man's groin, though.
But see, at that point, at this position, I mean, he's out. He can do whatever he wants. He can just, yeah. See, like, yeah, like a person, yeah, they going for a triangle choke and other stuff. So, so yeah, like that. Like, if you go back to the... Now, this is the real position right there. And before this guy taps here... Yeah. All right. So here, he's in the real arm bar position there. All right. This is it. Now, what he'll do is he'll use his legs to lock the guy down. Like, he won't be able to get up.
He's just laying him down. He just resting his arms over him now.
Right.
Legs over him. He's not using his legs.
Yeah, like, he's not using his legs to keep him down, which that's what people, like, that's what a Gracie would do.
And that's what creates the actual bar.
Right. Yeah. Because his legs are pushing your body down, mm-hmm. and his hips are starting to extend up. He's using your body to lift himself up, which breaks this right there, because mm-hmm. his hips is right there.
And you can't slide into it.
Right. And yeah, like, because you see, like, he's extended, and so you don't have enough room to slide up to his face.
Because he's laying down.
Right, and he's keeping his legs to keep you down. See, so like right here. Right. Now you can do that. But like right here, you're not doing that. See, like, yeah.
He gotta resist now.
Right, because he let him do that. You know, like in a real fight, they're not gonna let you just slide on up.
They're gonna
break it.
They,
like,
expected
look.
You to try anything to get out of it.
Yeah, like, they're gonna break it. Like, it's only thing I can do right now. If somebody gets you in the arm bar and it's in a fight, look, it's no tapping. It's break. I will break it, you know.
To cause you to tap.
Right. It's the break, man.
Okay, let's look at another one he's doing, man. Yeah. Let's see him in an actual competition, man. Not just demonstration. Show me what you can do to another man.
Oh, all right. Is it? Is this him? Nah, that's somebody else. Grandmaster. We got to see. Or maybe we put verses or something. So we can see him in action, you know. See, he's just
demonstrating. He don't want to show what he can do. What's that one right there?
Which one up here?
The father, this one right here.
All right, yeah, let's check that out, see what this is.
I mean, because you can demonstrate and you can teach. What's that say?
Grandmaster Bob Maloney versus another grandmaster.
Black belt. Nationals.
All right, let's see.
You got weak Kong
strength. Puss.
Wuss.
All right, so now they squaring up. This is all. Now, the guy with the gloves, he really don't stand a chance just because those gloves are too big.
He's a puncher. That's they just trying to get a point.
Right.
That's not a fight.
Right, right. Just whoever gets the punch, whoever gets the kick, one attack, and then you out.
Okay, but you touched him, that man's still viable.
Right. And then if you weren't all that gear, that means that you're
scared to get hit.
Right. I mean, if you. Yeah. I mean, who's the grandmaster? Come on. I tell you, man, these guys get their asses kicked.
In mixed martial arts, they would.
Some Gracie garage fights. Now, who do they give the point to?
The one on the top. That's not no fight, man.
No, they didn't. Gave it to the guy on the bottom. Yeah, that was
wasting my money. Oh, I didn't pay for it, though, did I?
Said, man, get this crap off of here, man. Let's see.
That just means they're saying whoever gets off first wins, and that's not how it works, man.
Right.
Because if you ain't got enough power to take that man down with that one, you're gonna get that one shot in. But if you, it's like fencing. That's all they're doing is fencing without a foil. I touched you first, ergo I get the point. But my reaction might be stronger than yours, initial contact. I mean, these aren't real fights, man. Put them in a ring. Get in a ring with somebody. Okay, they go one up there in the ring.
Over there?
Yeah.
Soku? Soki?
Yeah, let's see what happens in the ring.
Okay, 10th degree.
Okay.
This is back in the day.
Put that up on the big screen. There you go. Get that.
Oh, no, but that's not our boy, though, is it?
It's the same art.
All right.
And again, they're going to show him just trying to... Oh, he demonstrating a gun. See, I'm not going to put my gun up there on you like that.
All right, so it's just demonstrating. Yeah, some of these guys be getting roughed up.
Yeah, I want to see a fight. I want to see, like, mixed martial arts where you in the ring where you got to keep that motherfucker up off of you. Not talking about what I might do to him or what you could do to him. Show me your art. How can you keep off? How you going to keep a jiu-jitsu artist off of you?
Right. Because I can tell you that old fake escape that he did, like, that's not working.
I mean, I like what he was doing.
I think
for a non-martial to go up, if you're going to use that on a non-martial artist, you know, I like the idea of hitting down on that person, blinding that person.
Right. Oh, yeah, man. Nah, I'm not taking anything. Like, dude is legit, but, you know.
That's hoping that the person you're up against is not a jiu-jitsu artist.
Right, and then, like that, man. Like I said, like, yo.
Armbar.
He would get, the guy would just break his... Yeah, the guy would just break his arm. You feel me? Like, there's no need for him not to break his arm. So, the style, is it Soki? So, yeah. So, let me just put in that style, Soki versus... And then maybe it'll come up. With people who try to use that style in a real fight.
You're not going to see it.
Oh, man.
You're going to see them doing it on their students.
Right, but you're not going to see nothing. Because it's the deadly art, you know, never can be filmed.
Mm-hmm. Pretenders, man.
Let's see. Oh, this look real. Like, yo. Maybe he not... The art, this is probably just his name. Let's see.
This look like a movie anyway. It don't look like it's...
They rapping. All right, they battle rapping. Tell me you can.
Where'd they learn that from? Who started that kind of stuff, man?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm?
I started in Harlem.
That's what I'm talking about, man.
Oh, they battle rap, man. So this is probably another battle rap in their language. So, yeah, no fights. No style. Huh? Nah, that's probably just some demonstration. Look, now if he swings at me.
Okay, there's one where they're outside. What's that right there? The last one. Other way. Right there at the bottom. Right where your finger at.
You feel like, all right, let's check it out.
Look like a tournament. Right. That's a tournament.
Okay, so is he going to show some?
Oh, come on.
Now look, boy, that's how you got to do it. Your piece of wood attack you?
You cut it up. Well, Bruce Lee said that wood don't board don't hit back. Or maybe he's showing you that they're real.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Demonstration.
Yeah, man, that's just. That's that.
Get his ass whooped in mixed martial art.
Yeah, that's that Hafui.
Hafui?
Hafui, we can't. You don't got nobody doing it. Like, yo, come on. Oh, maybe.
What's the
demonstration?
It look like it. See how the guy's standing up there?
Yeah, but see, but that's how, like, man, if you watch those fights, that's how they do. They try to stand this way. And then, you know.
Because you don't see a ref there, so you know it's a demonstration.
Now look, if your opponent
does this, then you should do that. Man, that stuff happens so quick you can't even think about
right,
it.
Man.
You
right,
can't react. Man. And the thing, sad thing is, they train for somebody in their same art.
Right.
You know, they don't train for somebody else's in another style. That's
oh man, I tell you.
He did it with the sound of his voice?
Oh no, nah, he was he's like, no, did it, he just
yeah.
Keto we got.
With that one down there with the guy with the red pants on.
Right here?
Mm.
Or you wanna check this one?
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, let's check. This is Aikido versus MMA.
Oh. He's going to get his butt kicked.
Which one?
Him. the Asian going to whoop his butt.
All right. He got the boots on, the knee pads.
He ready to go down to the ground on you.
Yeah. Aikido, that's a Steven Seagal style, right?
Yeah. But that works on people who don't know their art.
Right. All right, he got the back tattoo. I think he's ready. He's in Japan.
They do stuff differently in Japan. He's making sure you ain't got no... checking, make sure his fingernails ain't too long. They're actually checking him, ain't they?
Yeah. All right, make sure his pink tights ain't too tight. Ain't too pink. Thank you. All right, let's go. No gloves. This is just bare knuckle right here. Okay. Here it is. They're feeling each other out. He lift up the leg, trying to get an idea about distance. Oh, all right, grabs him. MMA guy doesn't go for the underhook, so he doesn't know what he's doing. He's just trying to muscle him, but he needs to get under his arm mm-hmm. so that he can...
break his hold?
Yeah, and get some control. Oh, he goes in. He's on the bottom. The MMA guy's on the bottom. Aikido guy's on top. He's just holding him. He's going to do a frame, break the headlock. Is he going to bite him? Okay. He's got hip control moving over.
He looked like a victim.
Uh-oh. He's like, oh, he's tapping.
That was a setup. That was a setup.
Yeah, he didn't know, man. He know how to fight.
The Asian guy beat the wicked Westerner.
He didn't know what he was doing.
No, he was there to lose, man.
This is Aikido versus karate. All right, he's bouncing.
Aikido needs you to attack first. They don't appear to be offensive. Know what I'm saying?
Yeah, is that a woman?
No, that's how they dress in Aikido. Okay. All
right. He's just rocking back and forth.
See, he's trying to.
So it's more like a counter style.
Yeah, it's a counter style. He's trying to get him to commit to something. See?
Yeah. Oh, all right, but yeah, that's. Yeah, but this is cool. All right, this isn't a fight though. Alright, here, let's see if we can get some real. That's just like choreography or something. Yeah. We gotta put MMA versus, cause that other style, Grandmaster Black Man, I mean, he's good, but.
He talk the talk.
Yeah, but you know.
He might beat up another Japanese in his style, but he ain't gonna beat up no.
Yeah, if he would have fought one of the Gracies, I really don't have him against anything. Like, being able to do anything. Like, I really don't, man. Oh, we saw that. That was vicious. He just beat the brakes. Oh, here go. Did we see this one? Is this, yeah, we saw this one with that master. I think this is the one where, like, he's like a grandmaster or something.
Mm-hmm, cool.
Where he's like moving, yeah. We saw that one. He's using the energy. So yeah, we saw that.
See, that's the problem, man. You know, you hype it up with your students. Of course, they're gonna go along. I want to learn your secrets. Okay, you must go with me. See what the big fat black dude's up there doing, man. Right there.
Oh, he probably get his ass beat.
I don't know. Tons of fun, bro. Tons of fun.
He died. This guy, Yarbrough. He died recently, probably like...
Oh, it's too heavy?
Yeah, the big black one. He died maybe a couple weeks ago. Then three weeks. Yeah. But a lot of Japanese, they love those big, like, where a little guy fights a big guy. Now, I would be afraid to fight you.
I wouldn't.
Once he just get on top of you and just bite you like you're a sandwich. Just like...
He used his weight against him, man.
No, you don't.
You don't have enough reaction or speed to right. Do that.
Oh. All right, come on. All right, big boy walking slow. All right, come on. Come on. Come on. Yeah, kicks to the leg. He's just running. Yeah, you just do a front kick right to the knee. Bring him down.
Look fat in the back of his head, man.
Yeah. All right, come on. Oh, there you go. He just took that. Come on, little man. Why you running from me, though? Yep, Manuel Yarbrough. He died. He just died. All right.
A jump spinning heel kick. Yeah, it's like it's of a flying triangle. Flying triangle. My God. I mean, what do you do? You see? You don't even want to let this guy catch you. Can't get too brave, though. He's got to stay away from Yarbrough. He's got to let Yarbrough get tired first.
There's one thing you learned from this, though. Wow. Evade a big motherfucker. They can work. Tires ass out. He tired already. He's sweating like a pig. It ain't even had no contact.
Yeah, he threw like a few punches. He about to knock himself out. Oh! He caught him.
Yarbrough is throwing his mouthpiece out. This is not a very smart thing to do.
No.
Mr. Yarbrough, probably the largest athlete ever to compete in sports in any event in the history of the earth that I know about. I mean, I know Andre the Giant was bigger than Emmanuel Yarbrough as far as height.
See, he's too greasy. He can't.
Now, I'm telling you, it's going to this is not good. Oh, you got a big avalanche of a man like that coming after you.
This is for Japanese audience, man. You know what I mean. They don't have shit.
I
can't. Like
I would probably tap.
This is a spectacle, man.
Yeah. I would freak out. Especially if I were, you know. Takase is now fearing for his life.
Yep, that was some energy throwing there. Suddenly he should shock him and run the other side.
Yarbrough exploded there for a second. He almost grabbed Takase. And if he gets into a clinch, this fight is definitely going to be over.
It's not even if a fight. How can he...
And doesn't let go.
In good faith, announce this, man. You know what I'm saying? Listen to the background. Something.
Until now, it's been a very interesting life.
If I were Takase, I would jump up on the... No! Don't go!
Boom!
You've got to be out of your mind!
He nearly broke his neck.
No! This is horrible. This is like Jaws. This is like Jaws. This is like Jaws. Where Robert Shaw was sliding off the boat into the jaws of the shark. This is the exact same thing.
You've got
this huge behemoth.
He absorbing your ass like a thing.
He's got to get out of there, fight for his life.
Look at him, man. He ain't letting it go. I got you.
He's crazy. He's got to get out of there. Pull one foot out and then kick yourself out.
Yeah, big boy. And there's nothing big boy can do. Because he's not doing any damage.
Don't have a grip. Look at him.
He has his foot, though.
He gonna cut the blood off of his foot, though. He's going to have to submit because his foot going to go numb, man.
He's going to cut the blood off. Oh, yeah. He should just.
He hitting him on the knee.
Yeah. Who's bleeding? Is he bleeding? Yeah, because he was taking some big blows. Uh-oh. Yeah, he not going to get up. He can't get up.
Oh, it was a spectacle, man.
Yeah, it was.
It was.
Yeah.
You know, they do that. They match those fights up so that those Asians will beat a lumbering Westerner. What's that one? Is that the same one or is that a different one?
No, that's not.
Let's see that one, man.
This?
Yeah, they like to put them big.
This is going to be another same guy, Yarbrough, versus some other little small Asian person or something. It's going to do the same technique.
I guess you need the money, though, man.
Yeah.
You can't hate. You know, they had Jesse Owens racing against horses after he... He couldn't even get a job after the Olympics when he beat the Germans in 1939.
Man.
He had to race against horses, man.
So here's another. It's not even going to last long. All right, let's see. All right, oh, Biggie.
Boom.
Let's see, here it is. Round one, fight. So he, boom, big boy grabs him, takes him to the corner. Then comes on top of him, drops that 600 pounds on him. He's holding him. There it is. Just imagine this, how he smashed chicks. He used to anyway before he passed. Just getting all in between them. Like,
no, they used to sit on top of him, man. He couldn't. They wouldn't even go leak.
Yeah. He getting it in right now.
Too much fat in the way of even getting into a coon tank.
Yeah, he just beat him down. There you go. Good job, Yarbrough. Rest in peace,
man. He disqualified, man, because he's out the ring. Under the ropes.
He's like, look, man, you want some more or what?
Oh, he has to get back on the ground in position.
All right. So, you ready?
In the dick-sucking mode.
All right, ready? Go. All right. Ooh, Yarbrough goes into north-south. Big boy is trying to breathe, but he can't. There's nothing he can do.
He ain't punching. If he would punch, Yarbrough would...
All right, yeah. They punch him and knee him right in his face. Winner.
They booing.
He won because he's smiling.
Yeah. How did I let this... Gaijan beat me. Spectacles, man. They just spectacles, bro.
Yeah, he's like, look, man.
What the hell is... You know, again, another spectacle. They bread and entertainment. He's a kickboxer. He's a Thai kickboxer. They use their knees. Them not, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, I think both of them look like they top fighters.
Yeah. But you know, the thing is, though, this is all they leave for the poor.
Yeah.
It's violent sports, man.
Yeah.
They don't let them play golf, polo.
So this is what they leave for the poor.
Watch them beat each other's brains out. Now take that thing off his head. Check this out.
Man, yeah, that is sad. Just
think about it, man. That's all we could do.
Yeah, just beat each other to death.
Basketball, football.
Still beating each other to death.
Boy, tie. I kick your leg. I should knee. Come on, come on. You took my french fry. Pop out.
No, no. That's, all right. Ooh. He's watching it.
Oh! Oh! You can't do that. That was a nice move, though. You tried it.
Yeah, it was. It looked good. It was a I think kick. Both of them are. It's not kung fu.
No, it's
both of them Muay Thai fighters.
Muay Thai, yeah.
He's trying to get. Like, we need to have him dress. Whoever is the kung fu need to be dressed like kung fu.
Bruce Lee didn't dress like he was kung fu. Here's the magic question.
Go ahead.
You think Bruce Lee could handle one of the Gracies?
I don't know. I don't know. Part of me says no, but you never know, man. I mean, because if they would have took him down, they would have took him down. Then see, what? You know,
Brooks never talked about ground techniques.
No, but he did show an armbar in that movie when he went to the. That movie when he fights, he gets a cut across his chest, and he fights in the mirrors. Remember, he's in that tournament.
Oh yeah,
and the black guy Jim Kelly was in it as well. Mm-hmm. He does an armbar in that. He does an armbar technique in that. So
tight, 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 tight.
So you know,
Muay Thai, tight, 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 tight. Buck noi, oh, what's up? What's
that? That man, I tell you, oh.
What they stopping for? You can't stop him.
Right. If you get the takedown, you gotta go into the ground and pound. I gotta be scared now. Oh. There you go. Come on. See, would you see how the gloves? Just imagine if he had just the regular MMA gloves on. Alright, yeah. No, those kicks are good. Don't try to do no high kicks. He's gonna take you down. Oh. And then it's natural once you start to really get beat, you just go in for the clinch. But those gloves is not allowing him to grab them. You feel me? Like, that's what's hurting him, are those
that's
gloves.
That's not a fair fight, man, because the Muay Thai person doesn't do ground fighting.
Right.
That's why they stood him up.
Yeah, but see, and that's why he doesn't have regular gloves so that he can, you know, like MMA gloves, this would be a different fight.
Yeah, this is just.
Because he can't grab him with those gloves. Like, he's trying to, but he can't really grab him.
They will stand him back up anyway because he took him to the mat already.
Right, right.
This is in favor of the Thai boxer.
Right, right, it is. It is. And he really thinks he's doing something. And it's those gloves that's helping him. Yeah. Right. It's all right, dog. You got those big-ass gloves on. What you going to do with him, man? You're not going to do nothing but take those kicks. Look at him. He like, yeah.
See, that guy really a boxer.
Yeah, he's trying, but look at him now. He's trying to fight him off his back.
Yeah, this is farce, man. This is
yeah.
That's not a fair fight.
Nah, it's not. They not let him use the art. Yeah.
See, he's doing is punching. He can't do anything else but punch.
Right, and
he can't take him to the floor. That's all he can do is throw punches.
Yeah, and so he can't grab him.
Yeah, it's essentially a boxer versus a Thai person doing everything he does.
Right.
And the boxer can't do what he do.
Right. Yeah, man. He was trying to go for a leg lock, but he can't grab the foot. So
he won't even flip him. He can't flip him.
Yeah.
He for just, what purpose? Put him on the ground. What does that do for you?
Yeah.
So kill that shit, boy. Shit, kill the hoodo.
Yeah.
As far as dude, I wouldn't even fight. That's not MMA. Why would they even say that? That's a Thai boxer versus a boxer.
Did we see this one?
Mm-mm. What is that?
But see, even again,
Kung Fu versus
But you those boxing gloves. You can't, but you can't grab him. But he is boxing him. Oh, but he's kneeing him. Holy crap. Can he kick him at least? I don't even think he can kick him.
They're kicking each other. But think about that, though, man. That's what they give us, man.
Yeah. This is what we can do. Yeah,
beat keep the masses entertained.
Right, beat each other to death.
Gladiator style stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it is. It is sad. Yeah, see, he's not allowed to really use his techniques.
He's a martial artist?
Right.
Well, you. Well, so he can't. He can't throw.
Right, he can't slam him. Can't grab him. Yeah. And then the kickboxer walks away from it like, "Yeah, man, I'm beating all of these styles." But you're really not, man. You're really not beating these styles.
Because that's why they had death matches. death matches.
Yeah.
For that very purpose, you know, your stuff is that good. Whatever goes.
Right, man. So, yeah, man, let's just go ahead and wrap this puppy up. You guys, remember, we're going to be live streaming on Mondays around 6.
30-ish. Ish.
So...
check us out.
Yeah, check us out. We're on YouTube.
I'll make sure I shave.
We'll figure it out. We'll get it out on Twitter or whatever. We'll figure it out, you know. But until then, you know, we'll. So don't forget our sponsors. Who are we brought to you by? We're brought to you by BoKnowsMusic.com. You guys know what time it is. Get your piano lessons. Get your music lessons, okay? Step it up. You know what time it is. Go and create your account and get started today. Create a free account and get started. So, BoKnowsMusic.com. Also brought to you by Fidlu.com. Go up there, pick up an axe. He's creating this fresh, sexy axe right now. So, go in today and start. Buy your axe. Start learning the bass and get right. Last but not least, Weebly.com. Weebly.com. Create your website. Get your stuff going today. Get up there. Get your online presence and get this thing started the right way. Weebly.com. And we're out.
Peace.
My name Bishop Bullwacker, from the First Church, nothing but the truth. Deacon Kyle, Deacon George, Deacon Clay, open the door, let them in, turn them loose. First, I want to thank God for the blood running warm in my veins. That's all right, thank God for my life, health, and strength. I got a sound mind, I'm not insane.
come on, come on. I ain't gonna preach too long. Ain't gonna take the service too far. My sermon this morning, hell to the no, no, no. Come on, come on, come on. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no, 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 no. Listen. Sister Edda, Sister Ruth, y'all ushers, make sure that everybody get a seat. Sister Lily, man, go in the kitchen, cause when I get through, I need to eat. Come on! Fix me collard greens and cornbread and rice, chicken breasts, oxtails on the side. That's all right. Deacon Frank, get my dark truck ready, cause when I get through, I need to ride. Deacon Big Rob, count the money, come back, tell me what you raise. I got some people day looking for some blessings, but now God got to get the praise. Woo! There's an old saying, when the praises go up, you get the blessing coming down.
Yeah,
I got some peoples in the church, huh? And they still, they're messing around. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 listen. I got peoples in the church today hugging you. They claim that they love you to death.
They'll do that.
But time to get home, they on the telephone talking about they can't stand your breath.
Yeah.
I got peoples in the church smoking weed, drinking whiskey, drinking vodka, a lot of gin.
What you say?
I got the preacher with the night prayer meeting talking about can I get an amen.
Talk to him.
Every Sunday morning, about a quarter, about a half past ten.
Come on.
I got some faggots, got some bull daggers. I got some hoes and dope addicts, they coming in.
That's right, that's right.
And now they're laying at the altar, and they confess the sin, their sin, yeah.
Come on, bitch.
The time you see them Monday morning, doing the same thing again.
Come on.
Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 listen. I got kids dropping out of school, talking about they don't want to learn. But they're standing on the corner, rolling blunts, talking about come on, let's burn.
They'll do that.
I got kids walking up and down the street, pants hanging down by the knees.
Look at them, look at them.
Talking about that they're looking for a job. When I see them, I say, did it, bug, please.
That's what they need to
see. See all they ever talk about, brag about who got the biggest and the baddest gun. Time to see the copper with the bubble top. And they drop the Glock, they wanna run.
Yeah.
And now the sheriff got them locked up. Got them sitting in the county jail.
What now?
Heard the mama, she was crying all night, cause she can't get money for the bill. Now they're mad with the homeboys, cause they didn't put no money in the commissary.
Yeah, yeah.
Be glad you're in the jail, brother man, cause you were sure headed for the cemetery.
That's a fact.
There's an old saying that a hard head make a soft behind.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, since you did the crime, don't do the time, stop the baby crying. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, no, no.